When encountering a problem with the PI server, the clients or interface nodes, you may be asked by a support engineer to send you logs that encapsulate the time of the issue. There are lots of logs in different places. There's the PI server log, there's the PI message log, there's the PI PC log, specific interface logs, and many more. It can definitely be confusing which logs to send. Most commonly, the PI message log from both the server and interface are the most important and requested logs. Here's a few different ways of obtaining the server and interface logs. First, let's get on the PI server message log using system management tools. Open system management tools, expand operation, and message logs. Let's change the time span. Let's say the support engineer asked you for an hour's worth of logs. So let's change that to *-1H. Hit the magnifying glass at the top. Here you can see the logs. If you don't see the message column in your table, you can right-click and select message. To export the logs, let's click the log file button with the arrow going out and say export all. Most commonly, the engineer will ask you for a CSV file or a TXT file. These allow us to import them into system management tools or open them in Excel. Once you've exported it, zip it up and send it off. Next, let's switch over to an interface node and let's get the interface logs. This tool is pigetmsg, and this is a useful tool when on an interface node when system management tools isn't installed. Open up a command prompt and navigate to the PI home directory or the PI server directory if you're on a PI server. Then go into the ADM directory. To get an export of the log, you need to specify the start time, the end time, and a redirect to a text file using the greater than symbol. First, let's call pigetmsg, and then for a start time, -st, and we'll use *-1H again, and then for an end time, -et, and star, and then we'll use our redirect, the greater than symbol, and send it out to c:/logfile.txt. As you can see, you don't need quotes for the times in this command. So it created our log file. We can open it and just double check to make sure that it got the information, and it did. So we'll close this and of course zip that up and send it off. If you do happen to have system management tools installed on your interface node, you can also use this local PI message log up here, and this will also get you the local logs. If you see the PI message log on the upper left tab, that's for the server logs. This local PI message log is for the local logs. In this case, we're on an interface node, so it's getting the interface logs. Finally, if you happen to have the new version of the SDK, it's 1.4 in this case or greater, it comes with this new feature that automates this process for us. You open up support data and select the nature of the problem that you're having. Change your target directory to wherever you want to send the files. Select generate data. And once you do that, you can zip up those files and send it our way as well. For any more information or other logs that are not covered in this video, check the KB article or call tech support.